So
I'm not real big on cookie cutter gameplay where it's just, okay, here's the best build and the best strategy and the best most bestest of this, and at a certain point it's not really playing the game so much as it's just duplicating what someone else has done and calling it good. But to each their own, it's just fucking boring to me. But I've rebuilt this camp about 6 times, and then I've learned different things along the way. So yeah, here's a best suggestion, my 2 cents for what it's worth, about what to use for your camp. Now, I have the camp set up to where I can support 10 elders, which is the highest level that a drake will reach before it retires and doesn't require food and water and all that stuff anymore. The simplest one is for sleep. I still use just the basic beds. I didn't even bother unlocking the massage bed just because I've got fun taking care of elsewhere and it requires electricity and, you know, why bother? The bunk beds, I don't like because of the extra visibility that they take up, or, you know, profile for it. And I also use the sleeping arrangement for whenever I'm going to level up specific ones or if I want to check on a buff or anything like that. They're not running all over the friggin' place like Bebe's kids, friggin' out and trying to track them all, and yeah. Plus, I have this one placed here, which has Attuned on it, which is the perk that chance to not consume a crystal while leveling them up. So, basically, hop by, grab this buff, level up your munchkins, trade out your buff, go on about your business.
Yay!
For the entertainment section, I use puppet shows, and you only need 10 of them. There are other options, better options, I guess you could say, as far as stat goes. The swing I used quite a bit until I got the puppet shows and started looking at the numbers and everything. Swing offers higher stats, but I like the lower profile, again, just for visibility. This is pretty much the highest thing I have in the camp. Huh. Besides myself. Sorry. Anyway. So I mostly used the yoga ball, which you get around level 2. Until level 8, you get the swing set. Until you finally get the puppet show at level 10. And again, I like those. Lower profile, no energy cost, no water cost. Like the hot tub and that sort of thing. And realistically speaking, I could have built this even smaller by putting an entertainment or a puppet show at the end of each bed. And just maybe spread this out just a little bit more and had entertainment and sleep all in one section so the whole camp put in smaller. But there is no way in hell I am rebuilding all of these walls of friggin' gin. For food, I use the pumpkin patch, which requires no seeds, no electricity, no water, no nothing. They're friggin' fantastic. But you don't get them until level 11. Leading up until that point, I use mostly the cauldron, which you just dump resources into as you're in passing. You get the planter at level 2, which requires seeds, and they can kind of get hard to come by. So between level 1 to around level 5, hoard seeds. I would recommend. You can also, with the magpie, restocks on the shop every day, buy their seeds, even if you don't need them, until you hit level 5. Now, once you hit level 5, you get the lobster tank. It requires electricity and water, but no seeds. So no maintenance, and it's just fantastic. Again, lower profile too. You can put them back to back in a smaller area. The lobster tank will carry you all the way until you hit level 11 when you get the pumpkin patch. The water tower, clearly, provides more in a smaller space, but lower profile. So I use these, and also because of the way it unlocked. At level 2, you get the well, which requires no resources, and it's just automatic. So you use that from level 2 until level 5 when you get the water coolers, and I just left them in place and added to it as I progressed. So the water coolers require utility water. And the first one you get also at level 5 is the electric water pump. You get another one at level 8 that's better, but requires more resources, and it only takes 3 of these for all that you need for 10 elders, so I didn't bother swapping them out. Now, power for the entire camp, Teslas, water, everything, is just these 4 solar panels. As far as your progression goes, I use the treadmill you get at level 3. You get a battery at level 5, I believe it is, but it required too many resources to make it worth it for me, especially at the time. Level 7, you get the windmill, and in level 8, you get the solar panel. I eventually swapped out for these because, again, lower profile, and these things make the most ridiculous clickety-clackety noise the whole time, so... I have 10 Teslas. I have used just 8, and it's done fine. You have to repair the walls a bit more, but at this stage, yeah, it's cheating. Especially with the Terminators. They don't know what to do. Just confused about life in general. How you doing, sir? Don't worry. There you go. Just let it happen. The other ones are still damaged to walls, and so you have to repair some of that, but it's minimal. You don't even have to be here when the chest drops at the end. If you're out on some other island or whatever, it'll just pop up around where you're at. And I have them connected instead of between each Tesla to each Tesla. If so happened they go through the wall or the Terminator's bigger attack happen to take out one of the Teslas, it doesn't affect the next one in line. So their own sort of a internal circuitry, I guess. Kaboom! I never use this chopper thing at all. I don't even know what it does. The bunker and the ballista are kind of cool, and it's funny to watch, you know, little Mandrake Munchkins shooting at enemies and stuff, but they're inconsistent, and if it's nighttime, in most cases, they will not get up and man any of the guns to actually defend your camp. And yes, structurally wise, it could be smaller and all that sort of thing. I've just sort of got my little OCD open layout that I'd like to have, and that's just the way it is. But, yeah, it's fairly simple in design and not too hard to get a grasp of as far as going along, but I just made some terrible mistakes and built things that I didn't need to and wasted resources, and it took me a while to figure stuff out, so I figured, why not do my 2 cents? But, anyhoozles, that's about it. Thanks for watching. Hopefully this was somewhat helpful and not complete disaster. And, hopefully they expand on this game. I want to see more enemies and more weapons and more stuff. And we need a sort feature for this depot because what the hell were they thinking? Bye, babies.